My name is Sunil Singhal. I'm a general thoracic surgeon. My life is split between two things. I operate on people with lung cancer. The other half of my life is doing research, which is why I decided to stay in academics and to see if I could advance the field. Well, in 2007, I remember a case, and there was a young college girl who had lung cancer. That night, I went home, and we had just had a newborn baby. And my wife had put these glow-in-the-dark stars on the ceiling, and I was lying down next to her, and I remember looking up and saying, boy, that would be cool if we could make tumors glow. That idea stuck with me, and that sort of became my passion for the next 8 years of my life. The process for intraoperative imaging and making tumors glow is very simple. It's very safe, and that's why we actually can do it on pretty much anybody who needs cancer surgery. They come in a couple hours before surgery. They get an IV for their operation, and through the IV, we give them a tracer. And the tracer spends a couple hours seeking cancer cells, and as the dyes start to latch onto the cancer cells, the tumors start glowing. And as more and more surgeons at Penn became excited about this, a whole cadre of young surgeons really took this up quickly. We went into brain cancer, to urology, prostate cancers, and renal cancers, and now we're working on bladder cancer. We were also working in ovarian cancer. We're now moving into ENT surgery. This little first step has really broadened into a lot of areas. So I think that it's the perfect storm at a place like Penn, where the surgeons get along so well and we're so collaborative. For the first time, we have almost an extra sense in the operating room, something that's going to enhance our ability to see tumors and the margins and the edges and the lymph nodes. We're looking at making smaller incisions, more precise operations, with more confidence that at the end of the operation, you got every cancer cell out.